According to the National Examinations Board, this year's national examinations will start on the 14th of October with a briefing of a senior four candidates, and the exams will go on until the 18th of November. The second series of the exams is the primary leaving exams, which will be conducted from 7th to 9th November, starting with a briefing of the candidates. USCE will commence on the 18th of November to 9th December. Good news, however, is that the number of candidates to sit for this year's national examinations has increased with a percentage of 7.7%. A total of 1,280,172 candidates have registered for all the three levels of the final examinations, with P7 carrying more candidates, followed by Senior 4 and a slight decline registered at A level.
And gentlemen of the press, the Uganda National Examinations Board today releases the 2022 examinations timetables for the primary leaving examination, PLE, the Uganda Certificate of Education, UCE examination, and the Uganda Advanced Certificate of Education, USCE.
A total of 832,821 are to sit for PLE, 349,455 are for UCE, while 97,896 are to sit for USCE. Makerere University has already embarked on the study to find out the factors responsible for an increase in the number of candidates this year, as explained by Odongo.
Candidature for PLE has been very significant. Whereas in 2020 examination, the board registered 749,809 candidates. This year, the board has registered 832,821. That is an increase of nearly 100,000 more candidates. We have also observed modest increase at UCE by about 15,000 more candidates. However, the Uganda Advanced Certificate of Education figures have remained more or less the same. In fact, we have recorded a slight decrease in candidature at Uganda Advanced Certificate of Education.
Schools have been directed to display the candidates' registers to give an opportunity to the candidates and the parents to confirm the status of their registration. In case of any anomalies, UNEP should be immediately informed on their toll-free lines or on their customer care numbers. A strong caution has also been sounded to the schools and candidates to desist from examination malpractice.
We would wish to appeal to heads of centers to conduct these briefings, which are provided for in the timetables, personally. It has been the practice in some schools that head teachers leave this very important exercise to either their deputies or some other teachers. And we have noticed as a board that cases of irregularities or even examination malpractice that have been reported in many centers, and we've seen the root causes have been either because the candidates were inadequately briefed or they were not even briefed at all.
Over 50 billion shillings is to be spent on organizing this year's UNEP exams, and they plan to ask for a supplementary in case a need arises. They also anticipate to deploy over 70,000 scouts to oversee the examination exercise. Report by Jaliat Namuaya for the news.